Hey everybody, Brooklyn in the house. Back at you to do a read for the sign of Scorpio. So Scorpio or cross watcher, please do not claim this reading unless you're going to do it in a healthy, positive way for yourself. Now let's hit this. Clear ground for Scorpio, please. Thank you. As above, so below. There is no beginning, there is no end. It is with an attitude of gratitude that I would humbly like to thank Source, the Archangels, Ascended Masters, Spirit, and my ancestors, especially my ancestors, for overseeing this act of divination. Spirit, please help me to relay clear and concise messages for the higher good of our collective of Scorpio. Scorpio energy is fluid. I could be speaking about you or somebody in your energetic field. Show me the energy. Let's see who and how we're going to help somebody, anybody, all of you, one of you out there today. Here we go. Show me Scorpio. Scorpio. Please and thank you. Nice. Ten of Pentacles, Scorpio. Look at you. This is everything. This is the Disney fairy tale. This is having security and a foundation, some kind of legacy, some kind of wealth, inheritance, privilege, stability. This is having enough money to keep the lights on, the kids fed, savings, even pass them down after, you know, somebody could be leaving you an inheritance. But this is also having the family around you, the grandchildren, the children, the pets, the, you know, generations. Show me. Some kind of traditions. Somebody's building a legacy here, Scorpio. 10th can be of significance, or obviously October. Here you go. Got a King of Pentacles. Look at this. Virgo, Capricorn, or Taurus energy. Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus. This is somebody of very good character. That's very solid, stable, a practical leader. Okay? Somebody who's a good investor. Somebody who's very good with finances. You got the King of Pentacles, the richest king on the block. And the 10 of Pentacles. Who is better than you, Scorpio? Virgo, Capricorn, or Taurus energy. Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. Show me what's at the foundation of this situation. Please and thank you. Scorpio, it looks like you're coming into a lot of money. Okay? And this is wonderful. Yeah. You do have the Ten of Wands coming in on the shelf, meaning, okay, so you could have been over-obligated in some kind of area. You might have had the weight of the world on your shoulders here, but the burdens are being lifted, okay? They are alleviating. So, if there was anything that you maybe were too responsible for, or maybe, you know, anything that was weighing you down, whatever real struggle you were in that was burning you out, you're coming out of it now. 10-10. 10-10 could be of significance. This is an angel code. If you go into Siri or Google or whatever you deal with over there, you might get a message, a personal message from your personal guides or angels. Now, crowning you, look what you got, Scorpio. The star. Aquarius energy for, first of all, success, a gift from the, gift from God. Could be a gift from God, right? Beauty, inspiration, hope, healing. It's the star. It's dreams coming true. It's miracles. It's hope, like I said. Some of you might be in a spotlight, but you don't necessarily need to be. The 17th could be of significance, or the 8th. This could be happening by August. Some of you are coming into a lot of money here, and this is your wishes that are going to be granted and coming true. It's going to alleviate you of all these burdens. Could be dealing with somebody that has earth in their chart. This could just be you. Now, here you go, Knight of Swords. Somebody's got something to say. This is a direct, straightforward energy that knows how to articulate themselves. Maybe has some kind of little axe to grind or a bone to pick. But charging in straightforward and bravely. This could also be you bravely going after what you want in this world, right? Let's see. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius energy. Hi, Aquarius. How are you looking at this? Please and thank you. Okay. Somebody from the past, okay? Or people, places, and things from the past. Now, whatever this is, people, places, and things from the past, somebody might have a little bit of an axe to grind or some kind of truth to tell, because that's the sort of truth. Or this could just be somebody coming in from the past that has earth in their chart, right? Again, the 6 could be of significance. We have 6s across the board that's opening up your heart chakra. While we're on the subject, playing for the healing sound bath in the background today is 182 hertz, 182 megahertz. We're working on our solar plexus chakra. The mantra for the solar plexus chakra is I do, because it's action oriented and the element is fire, all right? It's located in your belly button. You know, it does unlock your inner power, positivity, and vitality. It raises your confidence and your energy, and it helps you manifest better. The color for the solar plexus chakra is yellow. So any kind of yellow crystal, yellow adventurine, yellow jade, yellow tiger eye, lemon jade, golden calcite. Let's see. What's in the actual environment for Scorpio? Please and thank you, Scorpio. I mean, this, wow. This is an amazing reading. That's exactly what I think I'm going to name this. Wow, this is an amazing reading. Because, I mean, you're sitting in a Ten of Pentacles, meaning, you know, some kind of financial stability plus family love. It's the whole thing, right? You're sitting, if you're this King of Pentacles sitting this way, or you're with somebody that's the King of Pentacles, very stable, solid energy, okay? You're getting rid of all the weight of the world that was on your shoulders, and you're having wishes come true and dreams being, you know, dreams coming true, wishes being granted. Somebody might have something to say, something from the past, somebody's coming in. Unless, yeah, you're looking at this like somebody from the past. All right, so what's in the actual, excuse me, environment for you? It could be quiet time right now. You could be resting, you could be recuperating, you could be healing from anything. Maybe this whatever this was on your shoulders. And contemplating your next steps forward. The fourth could be of significance, or perhaps the month of April. Show me, what's the best advice for Scorpio? The best advice is to reclaim back your power from anything that was controlling you, any kind of toxicity, whether that's addictions, sex, drugs, rock and roll, people that wanted to control you, codependent relationships, anybody with Capricorn in their chart, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. Not necessarily with Capricorn in the chart, but, like, you know, it's the devil in reverse. The devil upright is when, you know, something toxic has control of you. Somebody's got some kind of an obsession. There's abuse in some kind of way. In reverse, it's like saying, screw you, I'm detaching and claiming my independence and overcoming anything that's trying to restrain me or control me. And that's what Spirit wants you to do. Reclaim back your power. Now, what is the most likely outcome? You have, okay, there's going to be a new offer being made, something solid here. Look, you got the queen to the king. So you have a soulmate with a new offer. Just be careful. You know, there might be somebody that wants to win at all costs. Maybe whatever energy this is that you're reclaiming your power back from, okay? But you got the king to the queen. This is soulmates. This is wishes coming true. Just be careful. Anybody wants to start any kind of shit here, hold back from this. Hold back from these people. Look at this. You got this new solid beginning, Scorpio, that's going to lead to some kind of stability, happiness. It could be a reunion, okay? Some of you maybe just need to save some of your money here. And something's about to take off that's going to bring fairness and balance into your life. It's going to be a freaking shock and a surprise here, all right? Somebody, yeah. It might be shocking. And then you look at this. And then you got the Ten of Cups on top of this. And I'm seeing the sun peeking out over there. I don't know who's read this in Scorpio, but God bless you, okay? Now, yeah. You deserve it. You really do. So this is beautiful. Let's get you a couple of these. I'm going to tell you what signs you have. You have Aquarius, Capricorn, Aries, Libra, Scorpio as the most predominant, but it could be anything, right? Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. Show me what's going on here. I mean, this is going to be one of the best reads I've ever done for you. Not only are you reclaiming back your power and throwing whatever the hell this was that was trying to weigh you down back. You got a soulmate here. Love, money, inheritance, foundations, dreams coming true, wishes being granted. New opportunities for some kind of abundance and happiness. Fairness and balance. This is going to shock the shit. This would shock the shit out of anybody. I'm telling you, okay? It's about to take off rapidly. I'm going to say by August, you're going to know what this is, all right? You really are. The 11th could be of significance. That reduces to 2. There goes my nose. Off the chart. Off the chart. The tower is number 16, so that could be of significance. Or the 7th, July. I'm telling you. There you go. So, what you don't know and what you don't see here is the moon. Cancer and Pisces energy. So, this you don't know this yet. I'm telling you, you don't know this yet. You might not see it. This, you know, spirit working for you behind the scenes, I feel like. I don't feel like there's a lot, there's anything like really gazing. Some of you might be getting some serious downloads and dreams. Pay attention to them. Try to keep a little dream journal. Show me Scorpio, Scorpio, Scorpio. All right, Scorpio. Two of Swords. Some of you might be in denial when this happens. You're not going to believe it. You do have a Page of Cups, so that's a new beginning. This could also be a child. Page of Cups is also good news or a message that you're going to be getting about this. Could be a younger child. Could be somebody with water in their chart. Specifically Pisces or Cancer. But that's always good news. about, whatever this is, it's about to take off for you. Show me, Scorpio. Now, Scorpio, we also have, the King of Pentacles again. Unbelievable. Virgo, Capricorn, or Taurus. So you might get a message from somebody that has Earth in their chart. This is your soulmate if you're not with this person already. This is going to afford you the opportunity to step into this Ten of Pentacles and have your dreams come true. And your wishes granted. Yeah. Suffice to say, you have Earth in your chart, too. You also have... Okay, so now we have the Queen of Swords. Using your head over your heart. Somebody is. Somebody's very clear thinking. Somebody might be single here now, but they're not going to be. This is about being honest and perceptive. Very independent and objective. Very clear thinking and articulating your thoughts, your feelings, and your desires. Even your desires. Very well, okay? Good for you. So I'm seeing a red and white striped lighthouse. Somebody might like elephants here. And something about the eagles, or the team the eagles, or the group the eagles. Now you have a two of pentacles. But it's in reverse. So this might throw you off a little. You know, maybe you're going to feel a little overwhelmed. This is what I'm feeling. You might feel a little overwhelmed and a little, this, whatever this is, it might throw you a little off balance. I don't think it's anything you can't handle. At the bottom of this deck, what do we have? We have the two of wands. Yeah, making a decision about what path to take. So you might get thrown off a little, like your balance might get thrown off a little because you're going to have to make a decision which way to go. All right, I will tell you, let me just see. Let me get you a few of these. Twos across the board is some kind of full body awakening. Yeah, you got Pluto. Pluto, the 22nd. Again, I said twos across the board and look what came out. That's crazy. Really, really crazy. This is Scorpio energy, all right? So this, you know, 22nd or the 4th, again, that reduces to April. Let me see. Show me. Scorpio. Here we go, Scorpio. You have the sun. Leo energy. But how happy could you be, Scorpio? Whether you have Leo in your chart or not, the 31st can be of significance, or again, the 4th. Fours across the board. This is Archangel's pure divine frequency. They could be dealing with a Leo. Somebody has Leo in their chart. Something could be specific about April 22nd. I'm getting 422. Now, you also have Mercury. The 15th or 6th, again, June. Mercury is the energy of Virgo and Gemini. So, there you go. All right. Let's see. Let's leave that like that because I'm going to put more cards down. You got Taurus here. The 2nd again. I mean, if you see twos, that's your confirmation. All right? I'm going to get you a couple of these T's here. Show me the energy. We'll find out what the T is. Get you a couple of letters and we'll let you go. Scorpio, thank you for joining us. We love you. We're sending you health, wealth, love, abundance, and pride. I don't have to send you all that because you have your wishes being granted, dreams coming true, and forget about it. You're going to be able to dig holes in the backyard and plant your money, you know? Yeah, I'm telling you, for your great-grandchildren, let's go. Yeah, you got into you. Good chemistry, great vibes, positive. Listen, positivity. This is that King and Queen of Pentacles up there. It's you and somebody else. I don't care if you're the masculine or the feminine here. You also have moving on. Thank you, next. So somebody's moving on here. That's for a few of you. And lastly, you have romantic love affair. See, I'm telling you, I mean, caught up in one night love affair. Listen, some of you, this is it. This is it. This is love. That's it. Dust it off. Try again. Somebody's got a groupie. And somebody, be careful not to give too much of your money away. Yeah? Yeah. Even though you're coming into all kinds of things, money bags. There we go. That's what we're going to call you, money bags. There you go. Here's your letter, Scorpio. Thank you again. So, okay, you got a blank. You have E-I-A-A-E-I-O-O. You have D, two E's, P, P-D, police department, three E's, T, anything else? Here we go, G. Okay, D-G-P-T-S, post-traumatic stress. Disorder. Somebody's suffering with post-traumatic stress disorder. Look at that. Anyway, then you have a blank. You have A, three E's, I, O. Guys, thank you so much for joining us. Always remember, lead with logic and integrity, act with kindness and love. let things go. Fear is your enemy, and trust in God. Karma is real. Till next time, love, light, and laughter.